Gildan Media presents Your Coach in a Box, affordable, life-changing audio programs. The top 10 distinctions between millionaires and the middle class. By Keith Cameron Smith. Narrated by Lloyd James. Preface. Why I wrote this book. There are three reasons I wrote this book. The first is responsibility. I sincerely believe that each of us has a responsibility to share those things that produce good results in our own lives. Years ago, I started seeking and finding very successful men and women who were generous enough with their time to teach me the attitudes, beliefs, and ideas that empowered them to live extraordinary lives. As I adopted their philosophies and made them a consistent part of my own life, I also started to experience extraordinary results. In addition to having some very powerful people teach me, I also read a lot of books to help develop my mindset. This combination of personal mentors and reading has proven to be a significant part of the success journey for countless numbers of millionaires. There are thousands of great books written on success, so why did I feel the need to write this one? The answer is because each book I read revealed a slightly different perspective on how to achieve success and fulfillment. And sometimes it is the smallest distinction that makes the biggest difference in our understanding. Sometimes someone can explain a certain principle in a certain way that makes a light go on in our minds. And so it is with this book. It reveals some different perspectives on success. Many of the ideas in this book have been taught for ages by many different teachers. There are several key points, however, that I have never read or heard anywhere. I learned them through my own experiences of success and failure, which I feel will resonate with many people. I can honestly say that while writing this book, I was in an inspired state. People are amazed when they ask me how long it took me to write this book, and I tell them, 7 days. I sat down in a little cabin in the Smoky Mountains without any notes and just started typing. This book literally flowed out of the person I had become. Of course, I have been studying success for years and learning from my own up-and-down adventures from being an entrepreneur. I don't just teach the distinctions in this book. I practice them every day. They are part of who I am. The second reason I wrote this book is purpose. I believe we all have a song that we are destined to sing, and this book is a part of my song. I experience a strong sense of purpose every time I teach these principles, and every time someone contacts me to share how they are producing positive results in their lives. The third reason is legacy. These are some of the principles that I am teaching my own children to live by. One day, when I am gone, my children can pick this book up and remember some of the lessons their father taught them. Some of the books I have read were written decades ago, and some of them even centuries ago. Who knows where this book will be 100 years from now? I believe these distinctions are timeless. They do not change. They will be just as useful 100 years from now as they are today. So it is with a sense of responsibility, purpose, and legacy that I offer my understanding of these distinctions. A note on the order of the distinctions. I have arranged the distinctions in descending order of importance. This arrangement is based on my own experiences as an entrepreneur, as well as on the successes and failures of other millionaires. I believe that distinction 10, millionaires think long-term, the middle class thinks short-term, is the necessary starting point for achieving success because it makes you focus on what you want. Most people focus on what they don't want and never set goals for what they do want. The importance of distinctions 9 through 2 could be arranged to fit your own life during the season that you are going through. For instance, distinction number 7 may be more important to you than distinction number 3 at this time in your life. So whichever distinction speaks to your heart the loudest, listen to it and learn what life is trying to teach you. As you work with these distinctions, I think you will find that distinction number 1, millionaires ask themselves empowering questions, middle-class people ask themselves disempowering questions, is by far the most important to continually work with throughout your life. Always remember that success is a journey as well as a destination, and the road is always under construction. And now, the top 10 distinctions between millionaires and the middle class. Distinction 10. Millionaires think long-term, the middle class thinks short-term. Society can be broken down into five groups of people: the very poor, poor, middle class, rich, and very rich. Each group of people thinks differently about money. Very poor people think day-to-day. Poor people think week-to-week. Middle class people think month-to-month. Rich people think year-to-year. And very rich people think decade-to-decade. There are three primary goals that can be found in the mindsets of these five social groups. The primary goal for very poor and poor people is survival. The primary goal for middle-class people is comfort, and the primary goal for the rich and very rich is freedom. The reason that very poor and poor people seek to survive, and the middle class seeks to be comfortable, is because they have a scarcity mentality. They believe there is not enough money for everyone to have more than enough. The rich and very rich know the truth. There is enough money for everyone to have more than enough. What you believe about money has everything to do with how much money you will make. If you have a scarcity mentality, then you will seek to survive or just have enough to be comfortable. If you have an abundance mentality, you will seek freedom. The old saying, "Seek and you will find," is true when it comes to your finances. You really do get what you look for in life. If you seek to survive, you will. If you seek to be comfortable, you will be. If you seek freedom, you will find it. There is power in long-term thinking. It can and will make you rich if you make it a habit. Let's look further at each of these groups of people. Thinking day-to-day, as very poor people do, is where you will find day laborers and street beggars. They typically earn less than $10,000 a year. Thinking week-to-week, as poor people do, is living paycheck to paycheck and barely making ends meet. Poor people typically earn $10,000 to $25,000 a year. Thinking month to month, as middle class people do, is being concerned with monthly bills, such as mortgage payments, car payments, credit card payments, and other revolving accounts. The middle class typically earns $25,000 to $100,000 a year. Thinking year to year, as rich people do, is where people start learning about fiscal responsibility, financial literacy, and investing. Rich people typically make $100,000 to $500,000 a year. Thinking decade to decade, as the very rich do, is where you find business plans that reach far into the future. It is where people learn how to legally avoid taxes so they can keep their money working for them. It is where people learn how to pass their assets on to future generations without the government taking part of what they spent their lives building. Very rich people typically make well over $500,000 a year. Most very rich people consistently make a minimum of $1 million a year. Stretch your thinking further into the future. The longer you can stretch your thinking into the future, the richer you will become. Most multimillionaires I know personally have business plans that reach at least 10 years into the future. When I first started thinking year to year, my income really started to increase. I asked myself questions like, how can I double my income this year? How can I legally pay less in taxes this year? As I have seen this principle of long-term thinking in the lives of my mentors, it has challenged me to look further into my future. I now have business plans that go 20 years into the future. I spend time on a regular basis thinking about what I want my life to be like 5, 10, and 20 years from now. Then I create plans on how to get there. What would you like your life to be like 10 years from now? Think about it and start planning for it. Thinking long-term requires patience. Patience is an asset in the life of millionaires. Impatience is a liability in the life of the middle class. Middle-class people want instant gratification. I was like that for many years. Whatever I wanted, I charged to my credit card. or put a little bit down and made payments on the balance. Now I wait for the things I want because my goal is more freedom, not comfort. Rich and very rich people have developed the discipline of delayed gratification. Millionaires do today what others don't, so they can have tomorrow what others won't. The very poor, and middle class.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.